Hello everyone, welcome to the session of Application of Multiple Integrals, Part 1. This is Swati Nikam, Assistant Professor, Department of Humanities and Sciences, Walchand Institute of Technology, Solapur. At the end of this session, student will be able to find area of region bounded by curves by using double integration. Now let us see area by double integration. We will go for Cartesian coordinate system first. Consider the area enclosed by two plane curves x is equal to phi 1 y this and x is equal to phi 2 y the other curve. Intersecting in point A with coordinate AC and point B with coordinate BD. Now consider a strip parallel to x-axis. While studying double integration, we have seen that to know the limits of integration in the given region, we have to consider a strip either parallel to x-axis or parallel to y-axis. So, here we have considered a strip parallel to x-axis. On this strip, y varies from y has constant limits, y is equal to c bottom, 2y is equal to d top, and x has variable limit since strip is parallel to x axis. So x is equal to phi 1y to x is equal to phi 2y, and therefore the formula for area is capital A is equal to outer integration c to d inner integration phi 1y to phi 2y of dx dy. Now, on the other way, consider the area enclosed by two plane curves, y is equal to f1x, this curve, and y is equal to f2x, this upper curve, intersecting in point A and B. Consider a strip parallel to y-axis, so that on this strip, y varies from bottom first, which indicates lower limit, y is equal to f1x to top side indicates upper limit, y is equal to f2x, and x varies from, x limits are from left to right, so x has constant limit, x is equal to a to x is equal to b, and therefore the whole area is capital A is equal to integration a to b inner integration f1x to f2x dx dy. Friends, before we proceed further, pause your video for a minute and answer this simple question. Evaluate the limits of double integration over the positive quadrant of an ellipse. X square by a square plus y square by b square is equal to 1. I hope you have written your answer. So, this is the required ellipse. The limits of double integration over the positive or first quadrant of an ellipse is obtained as follows. This is xy coordinate system. I have drawn an ellipse. Let us consider region AOB because we are interested in positive quadrant or first quadrant. So, region OAB is the required region of integration. Now, to indicate this region, let us consider a strip parallel to y-axis, say PQ, while its motion, one end is on lower boundary of this strip is y equal to 0 and other end is on an ellipse. On this strip, y varies from, so y has variable limits, lower side is x-axis, that is y equal to 0, to upper side is an ellipse. So let us rewrite this equation in terms of y as y is equal to b into under root of 1 minus x square upon a square. And on this strip, x varies from, so we have to write down constant limits for x from from left x equal to 0 to right x is equal to a. Now let us solve an example for finding area of the circle x square plus y square is equal to a square. To find area of this circle, it is convenient to find area of the circle in first quadrant and multiply it by 4. Thus, the total area of the circle is given by capital A is equal to 4 times double integration over region R dx into dy. Let us consider the region AOB. So, in first quadrant, the region is AOB. And now, in order to get its limits, let us consider a strip parallel to y-axis, say PQ. While its motion, one end is on y equal to 0. So see, the lower end is on the x-axis, which represents y equal to 0, and the other end is on the circle, x square plus y square is equal to a square. So on this strip, y varies from y is equal to 0 to upper end indicates upper limit, y is equal to square root of a square minus x square. Actually, it is plus or minus under root of a square minus x square, but we are in positive quadrant, so let us consider the positive value only. And now x has constant limits, x varies from left side x equal to 0 and right side x is equal to a. Therefore, the formula for area becomes now a equal to 4 times integration 0 to a integration 0 to square root of a square minus x square dx into dy, which is equal to 4 times integration 0 to a inside the bracket. We will integrate with respect to y first, because limits of inner integration are in terms of x, and outside the bracket dx. Integration of dy is y simply, and substitute the limits, upper and lower limits, so that it is equal to 4 into integration 0 to 1 inside the big bracket y, writing lower limit 0, upper limit square root of a square minus x square into dx. Now in place of y, substitute upper limit minus lower limit into dx. Therefore, a equal to 4 times. Now, we will write down formula for this square root of a square minus x square integration as x by 2 into under root of a square minus x square plus a square by 2 into sine inverse of x by a outside the bracket limits 0 to a, which is equal to 4 times inside the bracket. Wherever we have x, substitute upper limit a, so a square minus a square becomes 0 plus a square by 2 into sine inverse of, it is a upon a, which is 1, and sine inverse of 1 is pi by 2, minus lower limit in place of x 0 minus sine inverse of 0 is 0. So it is equal to 4 into bracket a square into pi divided by 4. 4 get cancelled, and therefore area of the standard circle a is equal to a square into pi. Let's have one more example for practice. Find the area bounded by x equal to 0, y equal to 2x and y is equal to 4. So let us consider a region AOB. This is a region bounded by all the three curves and a strip parallel to y-axis, say PQ. The point of the intersection of the curve y is equal to 4 and y is equal to 2x is B, and which is obtained simply as with coordinate 2, 4. Thus, the required area of region OAB is given by A equal to double integration over R dx into dy. On this strip, y varies from. So let's write down the limits. C, strip is parallel to y-axis. So limits from bottom, at bottom y is equal to 2x, and at top y is equal to 4. So y is equal to 2x to y is equal to 4. And the constant limits are left side x is equal to 0 to right side x is equal to 2. Hence, area A is equal to integration 0 to 2, constant limit outside, and variable limits integration 2x to 4 dx into dy, which is equal to integration 0 to 2, inner integration 2x to 4 dy into dx. As the limits are in terms of x, so integrate with respect to y first, which is equal to integration 0 to 2, integration of dy is y, limits 2x to 4 into dx. So now in place of y, put upper limit minus lower limit, which is equal to integration 0 to 2, 4 minus 2x in outside dx is equal to integration of 4 is 4x minus 2 times integration of x is x square by 2, outside the bracket limits 0 to 2, which is equal to, in place of x, substitute upper limit 2, so 4 into 2, 8, minus, this 2 get cancelled, 2 square is 4, minus, lower limit in place of x, 0, minus, minus, plus, square in place of x square, it is 0, minus, 0 square, 0, which is equal to 8 minus 4 is equal to 4. So, required area A is equal to 4. I have referred a textbook named Higher Engineering Mathematics by Dr. B.S. Grewal.